Hey everyone, wow. Today I'm doing a video. I feel like I haven't done one in this style in a while. I'm probably wrong. Also, that rhymed. I'm off to a solid start. Okay, side note. Look at this giant water bottle. I have five, technically it's more than five, but five different products that I think are actually worth the money that I have not found a drugstore counterpart or a drugstore dupe that performs the same. Therefore, these are ones I can confidently, I was gonna do 10, but honestly, these were the five that stuck out to me the most. So I was like, I'm just gonna do these because these are the ones I genuinely think are worth it. You know, you guys know that I love drugstore products. A lot of the products on my face are drugstore. I can link everything I'm wearing below. But I'm also wearing the products I'm going to mention that are luxury. I stand by them. I think they are incredible. Most of them I own more than one shade of, you'll see, for a reason. All of these I bought with my own money, except for the lip product, you'll see. But I would have because, just trust me, I would have. So let's start with something that's beauty, but it's not technically makeup, brushes. You guys know I absolutely am obsessed with the Sephora Pro line of brushes. I have so many of them. There's like one, two, no, that one's Sigma. Anyway, I have tons of them. I bought them one by one. Every once in a while they'll go on sale. I'm telling you guys, they are worth the money. Here's what I've realized about myself. Anytime I've gotten a brush set, where it's got like, you know, 10 or 15 brushes, I feel like there are maybe four or five in there that I like actually use in my own routine. And then the rest I like kind of use, but they're just not quite a brush that's useful to me. There are so many different kinds of, let's say, foundation brushes or blush brushes. Not all of us like the same style. So for me, I've just been slowly picking one brush at a time up. These are so well made, they withstand washes really well. So the one I use, there are two, three, no, I see I use all of these so much. Some of my favorites, and some of you guys have heard of these before from me, the Sephora Dome Stippling number 41. This you'll see me apply my bronzer with today. I'll show you a quick clip. This is incredible. It's kind of a dual fiber, but it perfectly blends a color like bronzer, if you will. It's flawlessly. I found similar ones at the drugstore. There's an EcoTools one that works pretty well. Not quite as good as this one, in my opinion, but awfully close. But I'm just saying it really. But generally, their powder brush I love. I used for loose powder today all over my face. This is their airbrush number 55. The one I get the most questions about is this concealer brush. It's their flawless airbrush number 56. It's the perfect shape. I'm telling you, it blends out concealer so wonderfully. You guys have seen me use it in videos virtually every single time I've done my concealer on camera in the past 6, 7, 8 months. I love it. This is also a great one for concealer if you like a smaller one. It's the Airbrush Concealer number 57. I actually use this for eye primer when I use it just to kind of blend it quickly because sometimes I don't like getting my fingers all in there. Another unique one they have that I've never seen before is this Drawing Shadow Brush number 41. And it's just got this like weird tapered edge to it that does a great job at putting shadow on the lower lash line. Like, you guys, it's incredible. It sounds so dumb, I know, but it's incredible. The other lesson in here is, you know, find brushes that are gonna work for you. If you know you like a certain style of blush brush, find one really good one and use that instead of having random ones that you don't really love any of them. I mean, I feel like that I was just coasting through my makeup life for years, just using brushes I had, but never really finding ones that really worked for me and spoke to me. I know this is like real existential for these brushes, I know, but it's something I use every single day and it has totally changed the game for me. I have a lot of brushes. I need to declutter them again, but these are the ones that A, I bought with my own money, and B, I end up just rewashing and using the same one. So I really could probably get rid of most of those because that's pretty much all I'm using. Okay. So next, let's talk about cream shadow. I'm moving away. I still like palettes. I mean, there's no doubt. I have favorite palettes I use every week, but I really am growing to love more smaller palettes or like single shadows. This cream shadow from Charlotte Tilbury, it's in the shade Marie Antoinette, and it's from her Eyes to Mesmerize line. I have almost hit pan on this bad boy. I'm wearing it today. What I love about it is this is kind of moussey whipped texture to it. But you can use your fingers to apply it all over the lid if you want. You can use a brush. Today, what I did was I just used a flat eyeshadow brush, just a normal one, and got it all over the lid, and then I kind of blended it up into the crease. Then I just grabbed a clean, fluffy brush and just continued to blend with nothing on the brush. There's something very special about this shadow, that they're so highly blendable, whereas like Color Tattoos, which I also like, those are just, they're beautiful on, but they're just not quite as blendable. And I think it might be attributed to the whipped kind of moussey texture of this. I don't know, man. It's so gorgeous. When I will run out of this, I would buy this again. Now, I did buy another shade. It was in the shade Verushka. And it's pretty. You can tell I've only used it a couple times. It's kind of nice that you can see what it looks like brand new. I don't think this is a bad color. I just think it's a little bit too dark and too green for me. Now, I'm not going to get rid of it because there have been a few nights, like if we're going out in the evening, I'll do the exact same thing, but with this color. And it does still look good, but my everyday color is clearly one like Marie Antoinette. It's that formula, man. If you can find a color that you really, really like. And I think that's another part of the magic of that is that there's something about it that when you do blend it, it really does look like you have multiple shadows going on. Like it looks like I have a crease color on and stuff. It's just incredible. I feel like I need a cup of coffee. Hold on. I feel like weird when I don't have coffee with me. It's probably why my doctor said you need to drink more water. Just okay, you drink too much coffee. Let's do this. It's a little fun side note because I have the Invisalign. I have to use a straw. Many of you guys know that, but I have to also put ice cubes in it because I'm drinking it through, you know, and it's too, if it's really hot, you can't do it. So I'm constantly putting ice cubes in my coffee. It's very confusing. Let me know, by the way, if you wanna, I know not everyone's into Invisalign updates, but I feel like it might be beneficial for those that are. Probably be a lower viewed video on my channel, but if it's gonna help some of you guys making a decision or whatever, I'm willing to do it because I certainly have plenty of thoughts, plenty of like tips and tricks from having it for 5 months now. But anyway, where was I? I have no idea. Have I only talked about two of the five things? Oh my gosh, Jesse, come on. So two of the five items are from Charlotte Tilbury. And I gotta be honest, I had another that I was like, maybe I'll do this one too. I'm like, that's too many. But these are genuinely products I just cannot stop using and I've never found a drugstore dupe for, truly. And so these are the little wands that Charlotte Tilbury sells. So she has different versions. So there's the contour wand, the beauty light wand. So there's like the highlighter version, there's a blush version, and there are a couple shades of each, okay? So these are the three that I own and the three that I use. So obviously, because they're the three I own, okay? The contour one I have in fair and medium, and the way that all of these are set up is that they're a squeezy tube and you take the lid off and there's a sponge, which actually, in my humble opinion, makes the product amazing to use, but that's just me. I know some people don't like the sponges. But you twist it so that it's like open and you squeeze and the product comes up into the sponge. So I'll show you me applying each one of these today, but one tip I have learned is that when you are done using it, close it back, then put the lid back on because otherwise you end up with gunk everywhere. It kind of oozes out, but if it's closed, it doesn't. This is the second contour wand I've owned. I used up completely the first one. And with that one, it was such a mess because I made the mistake of traveling with it and I never really closed it. So that was really a bad idea. That was really bad. It looked like there's diarrhea like all over my makeup bag. It was so fun. So the way I use them, so I put the contour wand and I literally just apply the cream product right there, kind of on my cheekbones towards the ear. And then I use that Sephora domed stippling brush, like you saw, to blend it out. And it just is so seamless. It's so forgiving. I wonder if any of you guys watched the Tati and Charlotte Tilbury video. And it was so interesting to watch Charlotte Tilbury use her own products. And she also has such an interesting personality, you know, not in a bad way, in a good way, but very, very interesting. She's right. So many of these products, especially these wands, in my opinion, are very forgiving where you don't have to blend things perfectly because that's always the thing that will hold me back from trying like anything makeup wise is if it takes a lot of technique, it's not my cup of tea because that's not, I'm not a makeup artist. I never claimed to be. Anyway, it's just so easy, so forgiving. I'll usually put a little bit up on my forehead as well if I feel up to it. And then with the blush wand, I have the shade Pinkgasm and I will just dot a couple of dots. You really don't need a lot of this on the cheekbones and I will use usually like a duo fiber brush. This one is actually a Morphe M404 one. Elf makes a great one. I've talked about that a lot recently. Anyway, I'll blend it on my cheekbones. Sometimes I will just use a wet sponge that had a little bit of my foundation on it and use that to kind of help finish blending it out, especially if you feel like it's a little too strong. Slow down, Jess. Where's the race? And then the highlighter one, I have the shade Spotlight. And that one, I don't use the sponge. I actually get just a little bit on my ring finger and I love to tap it just at the top of my cheekbones. I'll put a little bit on the just above my brow and under my brow as well. And I just feel like this adds such a natural glow. I feel like these are like the trifecta of cream products. I love them. There's a reason I've repurchased one. I will repurchase these when I run out. I just think they're fantastic. I think the ease of application, the ease of blend, the natural way it can look like I'm obviously wearing makeup, but it doesn't look powdery. Like, it looks good in person, up close. These are the kinds of products I reach for all of the time, nearly every day. But not only that, but when I know I'm gonna be in the sun or in weird lighting, this always looks good and pretty and it doesn't age me anymore. So these bad boys are expensive, but they are absolutely, in my opinion, worth the money. By the way, I know I'm talking about a lot of expensive products. I can't shut up about the freaking Wet n Wild Dewy Foundation. I'm wearing it today. I think this foundation is so gorgeous, so gorgeous. And I did get a few questions asking, like, does it still have the same smell as the original, not dewy version, but the original Photo Focus foundation? No. All right, lip product. I've loved these for years now, and this is the only product I didn't buy myself. This was sent to me in PR long ago, and I've had these for a while. I wonder if they're getting old, but they don't smell weird and they're performing the same. Anyway, these are my two favorite shades, so I guess I should tell you what it is. These are the Lancome Labsolu Lip Lacquers. These are the most unique lip product I've ever tried. And I've tried some that are kind of similar. Like L'Oreal used to have one that was kind of similar, where it's kind of a gloss, but it's a very thin gloss that's more of a stain. So it ends up making your lips look like they have color all day long, but they never look dry. They never look crepey or weird. So I'll still typically reapply. Like, I would wear these when teaching all of the time because I could put it on in the morning. The stain color stays there, but it also stays glossy. And once I started feeling like, oh, I think it doesn't feel quite as like balmy anymore, I would just put another layer on like 4 or 5 hours into my day, maybe right after lunch or something. And it would look perfect the rest of the day, even while drinking coffee and water. You guys, this stuff is incredible. So the shade I'm wearing today is 216, and it's just kind of a nice peach, but it's not like orangey peach. It's not too pink. It's kind of right in between. You don't need lip liner with these bad boys. I'll usually put on one layer, wait 30 seconds, and then put on a second. Sometimes I don't even wait because you definitely can build up the color, especially with this shade. You'll put one layer on and be like, I feel like I don't have much on. But the more layers you do, the more colorful it gets. The pièce de résistance here is the shade, am I even using that phrase right? Is the shade 168. This is like a strawberry color. And it is so perfect if you're always wanting to wear a nice bright color, but you're always worried about it wearing off and looking weird and like looking dry, like if it's a liquid lipstick. This is the answer, you guys. I'm telling you, I don't know why more people aren't talking about this. This is something I a lot of times will travel with, and that will be like my red lip color because I know I can trust that it stays on all day. It's comfortable. It never looks gross. Like I said, I'll reapply. And these have lasted me quite a while, and I think the packaging is pretty too. It's got a little like nice gold Lancome emblem. And I did want to mention that the smell of this is a little bit Lancome-y. You know what I mean? Like there's kind of an old, kind of a perfumey scent. Definitely not a scent I enjoy, but you don't smell it when it's on your lips. You pretty much only smell it when you're first applying it. So another one that I have talked about ad nauseum recently because it's new to me, but I am like, oh my gosh, it's so incredible, is the mascara I'm wearing today. No false lashes, nothing, no extensions, none of that. This is the Thrive Cosmetics Liquid Lash Extensions Mascara. It's pricey. Some of you guys have said you can now buy it in Ulta. I thought it was online and I was all excited. No, it's Ulta in stores, meaning you'll probably need to check to see if it's sold in a store near you. Otherwise, you have to buy it on Thrive's website. This is different than most mascaras, than a traditional mascara, because it's a tubing mascara. And what that means is as it cools down, you know, with the room temperature hitting it, it will coat your lashes with kind of like tubes, but don't let that freak you out because trust me, it freaked me out at first. So the thing is, when you're applying this, it can look crazy volumized. I'll show you me applying it now. As you're applying it, the volume builds so beautifully and quickly and it can separate your lashes, but this is not a mascara you're gonna go in with a second coat 30 seconds or a minute later. No, once it dries, it's dried. So I know a lot of people love this also for like lower lash line work because lower lash line work. It just sounds funny and a little bit pretentious. A lot of people like it for that because it doesn't like smudge and flake off at all. That's just not what this mascara does because of the way it's built. And then the removal, all you need is warm water and they will just come off. It's so nice. This mascara is amazing. It holds the curl all day. Like the way my lashes look right after I applied it is the way they will look until I take this stuff off. It holds a curl, it's black, it's volumizing, it doesn't smudge or flake, it's fantastic. And I just feel like all of those products are ones I would repurchase. Some of them I have repurchased. They're just so good. And I do feel like nowadays we are living in a really cool time that you can buy amazing stuff for under $10 at the drugstore. I mean, drugstore companies in the past decade, especially with just the internet, we're in an age where drugstore companies can do it and do it pretty well. So I'm curious, what are your favorite products that you spent a decent amount of money on that you just feel, you know what, it is so worth it. It's so much better than any other version of it I've tried. I wanna know. So feel free to drop a comment down below with what your favorites are, if you have a top five or just a single product. What I might do as well is comb through the comments and make lists of ones I'm interested in trying. And maybe do a video trying your guys' absolute favorite luxury products. So we'll just continue to chat at the end of this video just because I feel like it. And I've been doing this in the past few videos and I enjoy it. What is it like where you are? Because it has turned into the most gray, depressing week. You know what I mean? You know, I just can't. But one thing I'm trying to be better about is not wishing this away. Because one thing that like hit me the other day was that with every winter I wish was over. That's, you know, 4 months of my life over with. So once winter's gone, I'm like, whoa, I'm 4 months older. 4 months of my life, it's gone by that I can't get back. Like there's so much life that we need to still be living even when the weather is so crummy. So I'm trying to have a more positive outlook on it, even though it can be hard. I'm looking outside at the absolutely just cloud cover for weeks, gray, you know, I guess it's 3 months, huh? Four seasons, 3 months, regardless. Just something to keep in mind if you're also, you know, have a certain time of year that's just really blah to you. Don't necessarily wish it away because even though it can be kind of crummy and it does affect our mood, I mean, I don't totally believe in that. It is still our life that we need to live and enjoy it and enjoy who we're around and our family and our friends. So I hope that you enjoyed this video. I hope you'll subscribe if you are interested. I do 3 videos a week here on my channel, Beauty and Lifestyle Mix. And other than that, I'll see you guys in my next one. Bye.